Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Don't shake your body.
Wake your fuck ass up. Then.
Crust out your eyes.
The most important artist of this generation. Over 21 Grammys. 6 consecutive number one albums. One of the most impactful voices to ever grab a microphone.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most talented producers to ever produce music, fashion, art. One of the most prolific people to ever speak on behalf of his thoughts, to trigger emotions and trigger thought of you.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most clever people to ever manipulate the internet. I watched him go from Sway. You got to hear my rhymes, man. You got to hear my rhymes. I know I make beats, but you got to hear my rhymes. Being on a train.
Okay.
Amtrak train going to Philly to now being mentioned alongside the President of the United States more than once. We talk about President Obama, but you forget some of the things that this man has said to really go against the grain and challenge thought
right.
fearlessly. For example,
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
And then another thing is, like, people so gay conscious now. Mm. That's like the whole thing, like with the internet. Every day somebody's, I can tell he gay now, you know. Mm-hmm. But back in the days, people used to have songs called like Get in That Ass or something like that.
Remind me again who's the original Superfly. And I got love at home, but I ain't fucking with that suit and tie.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome for the first time to Sway in the Morning here on Shade 45, the one, the only, the incomparable Kanye West.
Yeah.
That was a nice intro, Sway.
Absolutely.
I came off the top of the head, just a homie. What else can I do?
I don't even have to say anything. And interview over. That's all. That's it.
Good to see you, man. First and foremost, it's good to see you. I had a chance to go and see the Yeezus tour for the first time. I could not miss this tour with A Tribe Called Quest opening up in Madison Square Garden. First of all, I really appreciate when artists like yourself put spotlight on artists that influence you, you know, artists that you grew up with, tuned in to, listening to, and that gave you inspiration, like Tribe Called Quest. Is that why you put them on the bill?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's one of my biggest inspirations. Like, that's Q-Tip is like my hero. Like, that Midnight Marauders, Electric Relaxation, Low End Theory, a lot of the melodies and that particularly Q-Tip, the type of chords they would sample, mm-hmm. and that Pete Rock would sample, or like that, or that was sampled on 93 Till Infinity,
yeah.
which I felt was influenced by Tribe mostly, was, you know, what I was going for when I did The College Dropout, or when I always felt like I was at my highest level, was when I was closest to like Tribe records. So a record like Heard Them Say was an accomplishment for me. Mm. To have something that even sounded close to what they did, you know.
You yeah. know, I heard you speak about other producers that are from that era, and I love when that happens because I don't think we value our history
yeah.
a lot.
Yeah.
You know, someone's gonna speak on you. They already have started speaking on you. You've influenced a generation of artists who are now becoming more introverted, but more outspoken, more in tune with the different dimensions of what it is to be a person, not just, you know, your persona, but speaking emotionally as well. I heard you speak on Diamond D before, another yeah. classic producer. And then you also got Showbiz from the Digging in the Crates crew. What can you say about producers like Showbiz and Diamond D and how they influenced you?
Yeah, I mean, it was just every time something new dropped, whether it was like Soul Clap or, you know, just Diamond D being the best producer on the mic.
Yeah.
And just, you know, me having these guys to look up to, or, you know, and hearing the way their music sounded and knowing that, you know, I didn't really have enough money to buy the records that were needed to create a sound to the level of what the Beatnuts were creating and what Diamond D was creating. Mm. And, you know, you go through that a lot of times in your life where, exactly what you want to make, you might not have the exact resources for it at that time. So that's where No ID was the one dude that I knew that had all those drums in his basement.
Yeah.
Now Eric Schmidt is one of the guys that I know that has what I need in order to keep creating what I need to make Donda the best way I can say it is the post internet Disney, but it's more like Willy Wonka, more like whatever idea I have, I want to bring it into fruition. And it's not, Willy Wonka didn't stop making chocolate because he was making other things. That people even people want to marginalize me from the top all the way to the bottom. It could be, or who's to say who's at the top or the bottom, you know what I'm saying? But it's people who just want to hear the music that are like, don't work on nothing else because we love your music so much, so don't do that. And there's people at the top that are like, look, just perform at my, you know, son's bar mitzvah.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
Uh-huh.
And what Dr. King said about racism was, even if you don't, you know, perform a racist act, if you turn your head to it, that's a form of racism.
That's a form of racism.
So as powerful as that is the way I'm trying to simplify and repeat to the public, to everyone involved, that is what they are doing to me now. Because my demo tape is that Yeezus tour.
Yeah.
So if you take that Yeezus tour and you meet with Disney, or you meet with Zuckerberg, or you meet with Eric Schmidt, don't tell me I haven't written out the right plan for it. It's 20,000 people, four nights in a row, looking at pure creativity. So if I say I got a film idea, the Yeezus tour is more of a film or Broadway or play idea than it is a concert idea.
Yeah.
Watch the Throne was a rap concert idea.
Mm-hmm.
I like working with Jay because I can particularly get into the zone, a high-level rap. And we brought that Neo, Run DMC, you know, niggas in leather, Lux, chains and everything to the highest level. And now you see the NFL uses that same thing, bringing Tom Brady up on a cube.
Yeah.
Right. But would the NFL invest in Donda to just come up with the ideas in the first place? Mm. Like before there was even a Willow or the concept of it. Basically, it's like if y'all ever saw Semi-Pro and how like Will Ferrell was like trying to start a new league.
Yeah.
You know, Donda is like the NBA of creativity. There wasn't Willow, there's no idea. Willow is the guy, used to work for Donda, that now designs Jay's tours, Rihanna's tours, and Justin's tours. But he's still one of my best friends and one of my biggest inspirations, and also found a lot of the guys that work at Donda currently, like Matt Williams, who created Ben Trill, and also had discovered Lady Gaga and put Gaga with Nick Knight and everything. So right now, y'all watching almost a comedy of life right now. If you go see Semi-Pro and see how this man was trying to get people to come to the show, he was the coach of the team.
Yeah.
He'd have to play on the team sometimes. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that's what it is. It's like, where would Michael Jordan be with no NBA?
Well, can I ask you a question? Yeah, yeah. Not to cut you off. That sounds familiar. What I got from one of the things, if you go to Yeezus, if you go see this tour, which I encourage everyone to see, because I've watched concerts my entire career and I've never had an experience quite like that. Every song was its own story, you know, on stage. It was nothing was the same, and you were totally committed to it. You were even, when the lights were dim, you would call out in the middle of a song, yo, the lights are too dim or they're too bright.
Yeah.
When it was too much smoke around the mountain, yo, there's too much smoke. They can't get their Instagram pictures. It was really fascinating to see you so in control over this whole experience. And when I heard you tell the story about Lenny Kravitz trying to break into the world of fashion, and Louis Vuitton and these guys giving you a shot, and Pharrell, and then turning their backs on you, when you say in that particular field, will you say that part of fashion, the fashion world, is racist?
I say classist and controlist, because it's not racist, because they love Asians, you know. It's like, so it's not racism, you know. It's more like, who can they control? I mean, a guy that was sent to me from Puma literally came to me and say, how can we control you? But you can't control me. Yeah. I'm gonna bring positivity to the world.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm Christian. I'm about to be married. I got a family. I'm not trying to do nothing but good. but I'm going to rattle that cage until you let me do it. Like, I was interviewing with Charlamagne. He kept on coming with these old slave concepts of, like, you know, how you going to work with the corporation, but you going to diss the corporation. I'm saying, I'm just turning. I want to be recognized. You don't think, like, half of Drake's songs was coming at me to the point where I had to show up on that stage with him? Mm-hmm. And now he's like, okay, now you see me. And that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm like, man, y'all gonna see me. Y'all not gonna act like y'all don't see me because it's 50 paparazzi following me. So no, like, Graydon Carter, Vanity Fair, no, it's no powers that could be that are on the internet, that are control magazines, or that control media that can stop the movement.
But what I don't, like, I had Buckshot from Duck Down here yesterday.
Yeah.
He has a new sneaker called Triple Threat.
Mm-hmm.
And he couldn't break into the sneaker world. So he found his own partners. They got their own manufacturing. They're starting to take it from the, they're going to start from the bottom and work their way up. Mm-hmm. You're Kanye West. All that stuff you said about Marc Jacobs and those guys and H&M stealing, you know, stealing ideas.
Well, I was giving props to Marc Jacobs for actually letting two niggas in.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is, he let one nigga in, but he was a nice guy. That's Pharrell. He let another nigga in that almost lost his life. So I'm living in the afterlife as far as I'm concerned. I'm living in a second life.
Mm-hmm.
I got heaven on earth right now, and I'm going to make sure that I find my joy. And I don't care about the stipulations of brands or names. People always talking about brands and names. I'm just talking about simplifying things, you know?
Yeah.
Eve made Adam bite the apple, and ever since then it's been illegal to be naked. I'm just trying to help people with their opinion on the law. I had some clothing mishaps. I've had some clothing triumphs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But I know that I'm the next Ralph, to say the least. Like, people are combinations of what they were in the past. So that means, of course, I'm a combination of Martin and Malcolm, but I'm also a combination of Lenny and Michael, but I'm also a combination of Disney and this. We are coming in the future. People will be absorbing all of what was, you know, think about what the iPhone is currently. Like, you would have had to have 30 different things in your house to do what an iPhone does in one. Yeah. So for people to say the idea that Kanye West should only do music is ridiculous. Like, people told me I shouldn't do music back when I was in art school.
Well, you know, I'm sorry. I know our time is limited. I don't see you, so I'm going to ask you all. What I don't understand is...
I'll give you a little bit more time. We can go.
Yeah. Thank you. Hey, man, I appreciate that, man. Then you gave me time. You gave me my first TV. It's all coming together, man.
I gave Sway his first TV.
God damn it.
Like, you just ain't never had a TV ever before in your life.
Kanye, he helped you, Sway.
That was classic, though, man. That was classic. But why is it that you need these people? It's like you said, you don't need anybody to do these things. You don't need Adidas if you want to do a new shoe. Why?
Because you need proper production to bring something of a certain value. Yeah. I mean, the thing is, I mean, put it like this. In order to get, like, if I want to get this Japanese level thermal, right,
mm-hmm.
at a better price, if I'm starting small, I'm not going to be able to get the best price, and I'm going to be losing money to the point where I can't afford it.
Mm-hmm.
I went $13 million in debt working on my clothing line, and I'm getting Kanye Wested constantly with the prices mm-hmm. everywhere I go. So that means that if someone got less money than me, they charging me a bunch more because they look at me as the money. That's something they do. They take these celebrities and they show you this fabulous life of non-billionaires. That's not I'm talking about it's like 20 hot celebrities a year. It's 1,470 billionaires. Those 20 hot celebrities, if they were billionaires, they could make sure they're celebrities forever.
Yeah.
But they be out of there. They get the wrong hit. They get in trouble. They do this. They lose this contract. Blah, blah, blah. They are controlled by that. My thing is, I was out in Italy, even right now, trying to start my own company. The type of people that work with musicians, for the most part, is very difficult to get high-end, respected fashion people to work with someone that's considered to be a musician.
Yeah.
It's very hard to get the good people mm-hmm. because tell me this, if someone was a fashion designer and came to Dr. Dre, would Dr. Dre produce for them?
Nah,
it's hard.
Yeah.
It's just as hard as it was bringing Mos Def to the studio with Jay-Z. Now it's like, and that's what the College Dropout was. It was the combination of mm-hmm. those things. But let's thank Adidas for giving me an opportunity. It wasn't that Nike didn't... you know, offer me a contract, it mm-hmm. still was extremely marginalized and a slap in my face.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because they let me design, you know, it's like, yeah, they did me a favor by letting me design, but they let other people design. They let Pharrell design. They let Eminem design. I just designed the Yeezys. I turned up where they didn't think I could turn up that far. And they tried to hold it back. It was like that moment, you know, when I thought about taking Nicki's verse off of Monster, because I knew people would say that was the best verse on the best hip-hop album of all time, or arguably top 10 albums of all time, right? Mm-hmm. And I would do all that work, 8 months of work on Dark Fantasy, and people to this day would say to me, oh, my favorite thing was Nicki Minaj's verse. So if I let my ego get the best of me, instead of letting that girl get the shot to get that platform and become all she could be, I would take it off or marginalize her, try to stop her from having that shining moment. Uh-huh. So what happens when Mark Parker's riding on his jet with somebody come up to him and say, my son's favorite shoe is a Yeezy? Now, they could have been working on the Flyknit for 5 years and working on this project, blah, blah, but what I was doing was so disruptive. As disruptive as that Nicki Minaj Monster verse was, is how disruptive the Yeezys were. People hadn't felt that feeling since the Jordans. And by the way, the Jordans only popular at this point because of two people, me and Don C. Because Don C was ordering them vintage Jordans when the fours used to break apart on the sole. And we was wearing them back when I was wearing a Louis Vuitton backpack with the polos. And the brand Jordan looked at us and said, oh man, we got to start retroing them. Because when you think of Jordans, what you think of? You don't even know what the new Jordans look like. Yeah. All you think about is them retros.
What's going to happen with the red Octobers?
You know what Nike told me when I asked them? We ain't sure. You know what they told the store, though, of my boy that run a store? They said, if y'all want that red October, you got to take these 10 other shoes. Mm-hmm. So they told me they ain't sure. But then they told him, if you want that red October, but legally, we got to both sign that contract, Mark Parker. I'm going to put Mark Parker all on that Summer Jam screen. And by the way, Mark Parker, yes, I will still accept an investment in Donda. I got some more ideas that don't involve shoes. But if you guys are investing in the arts, y'all want to invest in this school in Brazil, y'all want to go to Africa, I'm standing up and I'm telling you, I am Warhol. I am the number one most impactful artist of our generation. I am Shakespeare in the flesh. Walt Disney, Nike, Google. Now, who's going to be the Medici family and stand up and let me create more? Or do you want to marginalize me till I'm out of my moment?
Or why don't you empower yourself and don't need them and do it yourself?
How, Sway?
Take a few steps back to go.
You ain't got the answers, man. You ain't got the answers. You ain't got the answers. You ain't got the answers, Sway.
Kanye.
I've been doing this more than you.
Doing what you more ain't than got, me? Come on, chill out.
You ain't got the answers. You ain't got the answers.
I'm asking you.
You ain't been doing the education.
Bro.
You ain't been doing the education.
Calm down.
You don't have the answers, though.
Calm down.
Because you're trying to give me advice about something.
No,
You ain't got the answer. You ain't spent $13 million of your own money trying to empower yourself.
Yes, but I spent hundreds of thousands and putting out clothing lines at a smaller degree. All I'm asking you.
Ralph, though. It ain't Ralph level.
But let me ask you this. I'm asking you.
What's the name of your clothing line? We don't know.
Kanye.
You know what I'm saying?
Because I lost money. But that's not.
Exactly. And I could lose money on a higher level, too.
And that's
don't
what
think
I'm
just
asking
because,
wait, hold
don't
up,
think
hold
because
up.
I
Kanye,
got the most
up.
Or the
let
least
me,
money.
Let me finish my question, dog.
Man, because, no,
let
man.
Let me hear the question,
you don't have
man.
The answers.
I'm asking you for the answer. It's a question. Why is it that you can't? You have money.
I just
you have
told
investors.
You, I lost the money because I did not have the knowledge
okay,
of how
so
to
you
do
don't
it the
have
right
money,
way.
So you don't have the money to do it. That's your answer. You ain't got to turn up, man. This ain't no fucking show, man.
Nah,
I'm talking to you as a homie.
Nah, it ain't no homie, man, because the thing is, the bottom line is,
man,
everybody,
I'm saying, you ain't got to turn up
you,
like
wait,
you ain't got
wait,
no, you, hold up. You
wait,
dis-
wait,
wait,
ain't
hold
no,
up.
Ain't no
hey,
hold
man,
up.
Listen, bro.
Ain't no hold up.
It ain't got to be no hold up. I'm asking you
ain't
a question.
Ain't no hold up.
I'm asking you a
ain't
question.
No hold up.
What do you mean it ain't no hold up, man? We here talking as civilized people. I'm trying to understand your world because when I go to your concert, I'm curious about what you're saying. I don't know. That's why I'm asking you the questions.
Well, I'm explaining to you
okay,
what it is.
Okay, but you ain't got to turn up on me man to man, dog. Fuck these mics. We could turn all this shit off. You ain't got to do this. It's cool. I love you, bro. But you ain't got to turn up. Ain't no. Don't try to embarrass us.
I'm not trying to embarrass y'all. What I'm trying to say to y'all is, this industry of what I'm trying to get into, ain't nobody never broke down. Ain't nobody broke down. We all slaves. So I ain't trying to disrespect you on your show. We all slaves
it
or something.
Ain't about my show, yay.
I ain't trying to disrespect you, period. Let me talk if you're going to have me talk. We all slaves. We all slaves. And y'all ain't experienced nothing right here but a moment from a movie out of glory. Back in the days, the slaves had enough money, they could buy their own freedom. We all say we slaves to Nike. We slaves to Benz. We slaves to public perception. We slaves to not looking, you know, what somebody going to say after the interview. Why you let Kanye do that? You should have checked him.
I don't give a fuck.
I love you, man. I'm sorry. I love you, man. I'm sorry, okay?
That's fine.
But look at this. This is exactly what would happen at the French Revolution. This is exactly what happened. I'm sure some arguments with Harry Tubman and other people talking about, let's go this way, let's go that way. But what I'm trying to say is, I sat in Paris and met with these people. I invested my own money and lost money. I made t-shirts that made money. I made music that made money. But at the end of the day, Lucy and Grange still cut my music checks. As powerful as my voice is, Lucian still runs 50% of the music industry.
Okay.
Francois Pinault owns Balenciaga, Puma, Saint Laurent, Stella McCartney. Francois Arnault owns Louis Vuitton, Celine, Givenchy. Renzo Rosso owns Margiela, Diesel, Marnie, Victor and Rolph. These guys got factories. These guys have factories. They run that. The thing that compresses me is time versus money. Integrity, money, and relevance. Because as I work on clothing more, I'm not rapping as much. So I'm not in the middle of that future mix because I didn't do that feature. I'm not rapping as much. I'm not having as much finances. I'm losing relevancy. The relevancy is part of my power that allows my brand to be big. That's what I'm saying. You juggle so crazy. But then you get a Nike that could simply say, the Yeezys did good. That was a good job. Let me get you some more so you can start your own line, because obviously people lining up for it. But they'll marginalize you and play you and talk about, we don't even know when the Red October's coming out. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? I'm juggling a lot of things at the same time. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all putting me number 6 after Big Sean on the hip-hop list.
My relevancy means
I'm wearing a kilt or because I'm doing something that's gaining.
Nah, man, that ain't gaining. Why you came number 6. At the time we did the show,
what you think
now,
though?
You something. If you, we what did you it now, you'd be number one. But
what
at
you
the
think
time,
now, though?
You or Drake, it'd yeah. be between you or Drake who would be number one. Yeah. That's what I say now. Who you think would be number one out of you and Drake?
Drake. Yeah.
Okay, that's what I think now. At the time we did the list, you had the Cruel Summer album and you had the Mercy song. You didn't have New Slave out.
I don't care about
okay.
the list.
Okay, but I do, because y'all you've been going around discrediting the list.
No.
And the people who do the list, there's not another collective of people in this business that more know more about hip-hop. These are the same people who said you were number one years ago.
Yeah, no, it's fine. The list is fine.
Okay.
But what I'm trying to say is, when you're trying to keep up with the list and write all these raps, but you also trying to learn about clothing, you got a whole hood calling you a fag for even liking clothes or being at, like, the runway shows. Like, you can't be a masculine person like Ralph Lauren and still love the beauty and texture of clothing as an artist and still love a fat ass at the same time. You know, then you got America, the president, constantly attacking you. Then you got people overcharge you at all times. Then you got your constant public perception being brought down. AG telling you when you're going to tour and when you can't tour. Everybody got an opinion towards you. You got shoes like the Nikes selling at $80,000 and the head won't even get on the phone with you. You got a meeting where every single door gets closed on you, like the Will Smith movie with his son. It's like that. It's like that for me. For me,
yeah.
Because I'm in that Michael Jackson position where he couldn't get his video played on MTV because he was considered to be urban.
So what is your
and
plan?
And sidebar, you got to get it. You got to. Charlamagne wanted this so bad.
Listen,
he
man.
Wanted me to turn up so bad I wouldn't even look at him. See, I could turn around you because I love you as my brother. We got history.
Yeah.
Me and Charlamagne, we turn up. We don't know where that's going to go. I know that we're going to hug it out. Everything is cool
and
stuff.
Yeah, we're good money.
Yeah.
And we haven't talked in a while. And what you go through. And by the way, I am always in your corner.
Yeah.
And you're right. You're in a realm where we don't know. People don't know what you're experiencing. Man, all these fucking names you name it sound foreign to me, bro. Because we don't know. But we need you to explain it. If I ask you a question, man, you can't blow up on it. I'm trying to understand why can't you? I don't understand. Now I do. Yeah. I don't understand why you need these people to get your music out. You got the internet. You the king of the internet. When you did your Good Fridays, that was fucking in there. Nobody did nothing like that. Why you need those people is what I don't understand. But you explained it to me. That's a fair question. Let's talk about your music real quick, though. All right. Because I know you got to go.
Yes, Lord, my drink is running out to this way. Goodness.
First of all, the Yeezus album was incredible to me.
Thank you.
There's a lot of messaging that I liked. Sonically, it was different. It reminded me of a time we were on the road talking to veterans, and I asked you about music, and you said, I don't use sounds. I said, how you picking your sounds? You said, I don't see music as sounds. I see it as colors. You know, so when I listen to your music, that's what I do. I see it as colors. Two things. I'm curious to why Pusha T and Big Sean weren't on this tour. When they're good music artists, why you decided not to put them on the tour?
Well, every artist that makes good music is on good music.
Mm-hmm.
Drake on good music.
Okay.
Wayne on good music. James Blake on good music. Frank Ocean on good music. You make good music, you on good music in my mind. I'm not marginalized by the brand of the deal that I've taken from Universal in order to cut some of my homeboys some checks. So that we can, you know, work on creative projects together. I'm not marginalized by the branding concept of good music versus cash money. All I do, text baby like, yo, we need to do something together. You know what I'm saying? We not each other's enemies. And everybody got to get their own, you know, maybe it's just a piano that I bring in for John Legend, executive produce that. Maybe it's an art package that I do for Pusha or beg him to take like a certain song off that I think sound too commercial, you know, because... You know, we didn't quite get to that with Big Sean on some of the songs that I wanted to take off and stuff, and it upset me as a hip hop artist a bit. And now he gonna turn up on his next one, and we talked it out and everything, and that's what it's gonna be. But I think that for me, I serve as an inspiration why I think we do go hard. I feel like starting from the bottom, now we here is Drake rapping harder. Because we pushing harder. We pushing each other. Like when Jadakiss and Styles were spitting, we had to push each other. And what I'm establishing with Yeezus is, you know, to take that stance, and I put my whole family on my back and I say, fuck the radio. As that number one most important artist of our generation to say that. And I'm saying fuck the radio, not saying I don't want to be played on the radio, but it's just saying stop making songs for the radio, make songs for the people. Make songs, and then some people could say, well, man, I don't feel like Yeezus is for the people. I don't feel like blah, blah, blah. Or make songs for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Make songs, because for me, I like On Site. I like all the songs. That's the shit that's enjoyable for me to listen to after I'm because when I was in Paris, man, I worked on that album. I'm sitting, my mama nicknamed me Mandela when I was a shorty. I wanted to burn those buildings down. It's a misconception that I said boycott Louis Vuitton. I wouldn't tell nobody to boycott a brand ain't nobody even thinking about no more. Nobody think about buying no Louis Vuitton. That brand old. You know what I'm saying? Nobody think about that brand. I wouldn't say boycott that brand. I'm talking about some relevancy, but I wanted to go in and turn, because let me tell you something else is so hip-hop. The music and the clothing are just as important.
Mm-hmm.
That's what make you hip-hop. You show people that you hip-hop by what you wear. So if I was able to be considered a person that wasn't allowed to be hip-hop, wasn't allowed to be a rapper, and I went in and turned around and became the most important not rapper but artist of the past 10 years, that's exactly what I'm going to do. And I'm going to be the first straight hip-hop, loud, celebrity, non-etiquette having, blackout all the time, fresh ass, super tasteful designer of all time. I'm gonna be the Tupac of clothing.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be a bigger music superstar than Michael Jackson. Well, you can't be a bigger basketball star than Michael Jordan. Yeah. You can't be a bigger rapper than Tupac. But it's a space and it's product territory to Steve Jobs that all the way.
And I respect that, and I think that's what makes you great. That's what makes you an inspiration. You're fearless. Okay, and we need that in hip hop. I've seen that with Pac. I see that with you. I've seen that with Jay. I see that with Drake in the way he makes his music. You know, yeah. People critique him by this. He's going through similar things you went through. Mm-hmm. But he's fearless. But at the end of the day, too, at the core of all this, what made me like you in the first place is that you're talented and you know how to rap well. So all this shit started with rap, bro. And my second question is, before
that's your opinion. Okay. That's not my opinion.
For me. But I'm talking about for me.
I started from my mama. Now I'm here. When my mom was educating me.
You missed the time. I'm talking about from. I didn't know you when you were born. I'm talking about. I'm talking about when we started hanging out. You used to come up to MTV, and it was your talent that you as a producer. Your mind wasn't where you are. You ain't the same person today that you were when we met.
Yes, I was. Yes, I am.
You're a lot more mature. You're a father now. You're not the same person.
Yeah, in a way, but I've been the same person since age zero.
Okay, okay.
I was born to be me.
Hey, man, can you do a rap for us? Can you rap for us, bro? Can I get a verse?
I ain't got no new verse.
You ain't got a new verse?
I ain't got no new
man,
verse.
Man, last time we talked, you came off the top of the head. Let's take it back to the basics, man.
Okay.
All right, let's do it. Fuck it. Kanye West, Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5. Wonder what you got.
Is Eurobeat?
You don't want that one? You be the last person to pick a beat, man. tell me
shit,
the beat.
We're going to be here until tomorrow.
Yeah. Okay. I sense you feeling that a little bit.
But I like Nine Inch Nails, though. So what you,
talk about what you talking about, man.
And just put it in rap form?
Yeah, talk about what you talking about. Talk about them names, these corporations, this marginalization.
I can make shit rhyme. I can make shit rhyme if I'm feel like, even if I don't. So I just might not, cause I don't want, and I'm just gonna freestyle for the first time with a freestyle that don't even go together. Oh, no rhymes. That's my new shit. Nothing rhyme. How that sound? Uh-oh. Wow. You ain't got the answer, Sway. I can say it all night.
That's the next one. You ain't got the answer, Sway. Damn, man. Hey, wait, hold up. I started the year off with I gave Sway his first TV.
Now what is it?
I got to end the year off with you ain't got the answer, Sway.
Hashtag it.
Dog, man, you've been making me have a great year, bro. Thank you, man. That's your rap? That's what you're going to leave us with?
Yeah, that was the first freestyle that had absolutely no rhymes.
That's what you're going to leave us with, right?
Yeah.
That's it, huh?
Yeah.
What? That's what?
That's it.
That's it, huh?
Yeah.
What about a written?
No.
No? But you still love to rap, though.
I do.
Okay, cool, man. Hey, listen, brother. Check this out, man. It's always good to see you. All right.
Hug it out, bro.
And good luck on your plight and whatever you need from us, man. Get at us, man. All right? And nigga, check this out. I don't use the word nigga. I'm not a nigga user. Don't yell at me again on the mic. All right?
All right, love, okay, man. No disrespect. Yeah. I love you. Okay. I love you, Sway.
All right, I love you, too.
I ain't mean to turn up at your show, man.
No, I don't. It's life, baby. This ain't... Don't marginalize me to this show, man.
Yes,
don't do that to me, man. All right? This is life. But I love you, man. Kanye West, ladies and gentlemen.
You know we argue. We out anywhere else anyway. So that's how we talk.
That's true, man. We do get at each other.
It's Sway in the Morning. Only on Shade 45.